But we didn't talk about any of this during the break. You have an update on our pal Virgil.
That's right.
We can't get enough of Virgil. Well, Ant loves Virgil. Ant loves the Virgil
stories. I love the Virgil stories. Whenever our own Sam Roberts goes to these events, Virgil from WWF, or yeah, it was F at the time,
it was definitely F.
He was Ted DiBiase's guy, the Million Dollar Man.
Right.
He was like his little sidekick.
Technically his bodyguard.
He would throw a few punches in there if he saw Ted was in trouble.
Though. He didn't take many bumps. Not many.
So Virgil always ends up at these things, and Sam just tracks him down.
Hot on his trail.
He knows the subtle things to look for. The echo in the room, yes. The empty table, the complete lack of a line in front of his merchandise. And it's the same picture every time. I actually, when you tweeted the picture,
I thought it was an old one.
I got back to Sam and was like, that cannot be a new picture. That's the same one that you took like years ago.
I wanted a chronicle.
Wait, does he know you're taking his picture?
No.
Okay. Have we explained to the people that there's never a line for Virgil for the new people that are checking out this bit?
Well, this photo that you're looking at was taken at the very beginning of the weekend. This is this is when the convention floor opened on Friday.
When it was hot. All the people that were waiting for Virgil.
They're just running to their favorite celebrity.
And then I figured on the way out, we would bookend it and have a picture of his table end of the day on Sunday.
So we're looking at two pictures that are very similar, and it doesn't look like he moved a lot of merchandise or autographs.
Nothing even looks mussed. There doesn't seem to be any scuff marks on the floor in front of the table.
There's
nothing going on there.
Was this a lunch break? Are you misrepresenting this? Was there people in front of Virgil ever?
No.
Every once in a while?
There was never more than two people in front of Virgil.
And an average person there, do they have a small group at all times, or?
Yeah, I mean, everybody's going to have some downtime, but sure, there's nobody who consistently has an empty table on the level of Virgil.
Virgil.
He goes to every convention. I go to every convention, so I know he goes to every convention. I've never seen him with a line, once.
How can he afford to do these things? I mean,
I don't know.
It's got to cost him a minimum of $1,000 to go out there and set up for this.
Why did E-Rock ask him to sign his fucking belt?
I didn't. Fuck that guy.
Oh, shit.
No, because he ruined the photo and he ruined the belt, and then I had to pay for all of that.
The $1 million belt?
Yeah.
Ted DiBiase only?
Only him, and he walks into the photo and grabs the belt and puts his arm around me to get into the photo.
I'm a huge fan of the go-to bits on this show.
And then I can't get
enough of this.
I know. Please.
Did he charge you for it?
I was paying Ted, and then all of a sudden...
Thank you very much, Eric!
Why wouldn't you want Virgil, though? Those guys were inseparable.
Because you could get him at any event.
So you got him,
like, him and Lou Ferrigno are at everything.
I did get an interview with Lou Ferrigno.
Ah, how'd that go again?
If you see up here on the TV, that's the photo I tell everybody I have with Ted DiBiase.
That's Ted DiBiase?
Are you sure?
Ted got fat.
Can I say something?
That's Eric.
Million pound man. Oh, wait. Yeah.
I want you to look closely at the $1 million belt.
Yeah.
Why is one of Eric's hands black?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Wait a minute.
I actually didn't even notice that.
That is Virgil's hand holding the belt.
You had to crop your picture?
Now, you look so annoyed.
This is the photo I tell everyone. Oh, yeah, I have a Ted DiBiase photo. This is the one I don't show anybody.
Oh, man.
He walked right into the photo.
Why would he do that?
Now we're looking at a picture, obviously, of Ted DiBiase and Virgil with E-Rock.
Do you know why he did that?
Why?
So then, once the picture was taken, he could demand E-Rock give him money.
I had to pay for him.
This is the Virgil scam.
Now, you didn't tell him, Virgil, get in here.
No. In fact, I didn't tell him to touch my belt because I put it down while talking with Mr. DiBiase. Virgil goes, oh, I'll sign it so you have two signatures from the only people who ever held the belt. And I'm like, Stone Cold Steve Austin held that belt too, but I didn't ask him to sign it
because
it's Ted's belt.
Oh, my God.
And he just signed it without me looking at it.
Did you pay him?
I didn't pay for the belt, but I had to pay for the damn photo.
Why would you pay for the photo?
Because it was a bundle thing. I don't remember. I wish I did now, but I had to pay for fucking Virgil.
About, though, how much did you pay?
You got robbed,
That had to have been...
He scammed you.
$20-$30
No, it was
he
more
than
that.
He three-car money your
ass.
Like
he really did.
He fucking got you.
E-Rock thinks it was
$80.
I think
it was like $80.
You paid $80
$80? It was a thing with Ted to get a photo and for him to sign something that wasn't something that he was providing. Like
for yeah, but $80? That's for Ted.
Because Virgil jumped in on it because he signed it plus the photo. And I said, I'm not paying for Virgil signing the belt.
So they charge you for two photos and an autograph?
Yeah.
Still, $80 is way
too
much.
Holy shit, you got robbed. Yeah,
this is Virgil's whole thing. Like, because there's nobody that comes to his table. So when a few people do, he just scams them. Like, the first time I saw him at a convention, I got a picture and an autograph. And I go, how much is, because he doesn't post his prices, because that's part of his deal.
What a scumbag.
And so, because that way you go, like, how much are the prices?
Wait, goes, can you do the play acting that I really enjoyed during the break? You and Ann had some fucking chemistry.
Well, like, so here's what happened.
Let's go through it again.
I'll tell you the story of what happened this weekend.
Okay.
Because I went up to Virgil and asked for an interview, and he said, not right now, but not right now. I'm making some money.
Was there anyone around?
There was one guy there.
I got to make some money, motherfucker.
To stand. And
did you ever get, you had to get audio Virgil while you're out there.
I couldn't.
Fuck. Oh, man.
What happened? You said, okay.
So I decided to wait and watch the transaction because I know what my experience has been like with him. Yeah. So the guy comes up to him and he starts looking at the photos he has laid out on the table.
Mm-hmm. And now Virgil's smelling a mark. Yeah.
So he starts going, hey, buddy, how about a little old school? How about a little old school?
Old school?
You like the old stuff, right?
Well, old
like
stuff.
Like a throwback, you know.
Oh, I like that, Virgil, yeah.
You used to watch Virgil on TV, right?
Yeah. What do you got?
Which picture you like here? What's your favorite picture here? See that one? That's all the old school guys in one picture. You see that?
Yeah, I like that one.
You see that? That's me on the cover of the magazine.
How much do you get for that
you
one,
You want this picture? You like which one's your favorite picture? You like that picture?
Well, yeah, I like that
all
one
right,
a lot.
You want me? I'll sign it for you. You want me to sign? Here, let me sign it for you. What's
I would
your name?
Like a signature there. Anthony.
What's your name? Anthony. All right, Anthony.
See, I need to know how much this.
Come back. Yeah, let's get a picture. You want to get a picture?
With
come back
Virgil?
Around here. We'll put the belt down. Right. We'll get a picture.
All right. That
we'll
sounds
get a
cool.
We'll
all
get
right.
A picture.
Let me
all
come
right.
back there.
There you go. Say cheese.
Cheese.
All right. And that's 60. Wait. You didn't get one
Virgil.
With your girlfriend.
What?
You want to get a picture, miss?
I'm here. I don't have a girlfriend.
Come back around.
Oh, wait a minute.
Come back around. We'll get her in a picture.
Yeah?
That'll just be 70 then with both pictures.
What?
And then
it's $70.
And then he.
But he never.
That's 70.
Front.
That's 70.
You're right. That's three card money.
That's three card money. That's old carny. Old carnies shit. Do it.
Virgil's not worth a $15.
That's like
combo.
When they.
No.
That's when you go to the carnivals and they go, yeah, just try. Okay,
throw
try
the
one,
dart.
Try to hit the
balloon with the dart. Here. Try again.
Do you think guys waste their money who have been trying to go see somebody else so they don't have that much money?
Oh, $100
and they waste it on him?
And they leave with a Virgil picture.
Wow.
And meanwhile, they wanted, like, something cool.
Tetley or somebody.
Virgil
yeah.
should be...
Tetley.
But that sounds exhausting.
Virgil should be charging $10 for an autograph and $5 for a photo. $15 combo.
You see, a good combo would be, like, if you get the Jerry Sherbert double scoop, where you get the picture, and you both get to hold, like, scoopers banging into each other.
That would be cool.
Like, you're both hitting the Sherbert scoopers.
I saw some really good photoshops of your wrestling
Jerry
character.
Sherbert. Yeah.
Jerry Sherbert.
Is that his name?
I think so. It was something
should be if it isn't.
That's the beauty of going on vacation. You get to forget about stuff like Jerry Sherbert.
Everybody thinks he's French. They call him the amazing Sherbert. And
no,
like,
oh, it's Sherbert. Wow.
Sherbert.
Really? Yeah. Virgil did the same thing to me in Comic Con. That's how I know this is in 2008.
That's the same scam. And were you taken?
How much is it? He goes, it's 20. And I go, oh, okay, 20. I said, for picture and autograph. He goes, picture and autograph, 20. I go, okay.
Each.
And then so he signs it, and he goes, all right, so I'll sign it for you, so that'll be 20. And then he goes, you want a picture, right? And I go, yeah. And he goes, okay, so just 15 more. And I go, okay. And so I go, and I pose for the picture, and he's like, so that's 45.
What?
Wait, how?
And the numbers just keep going all over the place.
35, maybe, and then.
And I'm like, all I got is 30. And he goes, right, 30, all right, that's fine.
Oh, motherfuck that guy.
Because he still got more than the 20.
And I just gave him
still did well.
30 cash and felt raped. And
did you want to buy that stuff for $30?
Hell no.
No. But once, but in my mind, I was like, the picture, the autograph, and the story.
Yeah.
Is worth the 30.
Yeah, you know.
I want to go up to him and fucking. I never.
It's not worth 80.
Where were these, by the way?
Iraq with $80, and it's his own belt. He fucked up.
He fucked
your picture up, and
you can't erase his signature.
No, because the ink is in the foam matting on the back there. You'd have to cut it out.
Oh man,
it ain't worth erasing if he did hold the belt. I mean, it's like just get Steve Austin on it, so you have all of them.
Yeah, that's no, but
I don't understand why you wouldn't want him on there. Because I'm telling you, they went as a pair.
Steve Austin was here recently. Why didn't you get him then?
I didn't think about it.
Stone Cold's not signing anything that Virgil signed. That's what he'd probably say. Fuck that. Well.
Oh, yes.
Virgil's signature devalues the belt. 100%.
Oh, yeah.
100%.
Really? That should just be Ted DiBiase.
A $1 million belt signed by Ted DiBiase is worth more than a $1 million belt signed by Ted DiBiase and Virgil.
Why doesn't E-Rock start over?
Maybe you need to get a new belt.
Get a new belt.
Oh, sweetie needs a belt.
Just like the ones for your pants. Get a new belt.
No, see, that's not necessary.
It really isn't. You're right.
No, it is, though, because they burst.
Oh, jeez.
Your belts act like fucking Fredo coming in the room.
We got two Virgil things coming in. Tim in Baltimore goes, Virgil was at the Baltimore Car Show in February. I never saw him sign one autograph the 3 hours I was there. I wanted to take a picture and send it to the show, but he was just too pathetic looking, and I started feeling bad for him.
And that's what I'm saying. This was in Anaheim. He goes all over the country.
Oh, yeah.
Where were you? I don't know how Anaheim. He affords it.
That's his gig now.
Maybe he went to Anaheim this weekend?
Maybe he's got a little side thing going on.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, another thing, Sam can contest it, that Virgil...
I contest.
Virgil will promote that Ted DiBiase might be coming to the event.
He has
the big banner that says Ted DiBiase and Virgil, WWE superstar.
Because then you go over and you ask him the question, is Ted DiBiase coming? He says, yeah, maybe later, just so he has an affirmative answer to keep you there.
Right.
And then he doesn't let you leave. Then he sucks you in and he keeps talking to you until he gets the $70 or he'll go, you know, as high as he can go. 80.
So what, you flew yourself out there?
I paid for it, and then the company's going to pay me back.
Uh-huh. Oh, you were out there for
I was covering it for WonderCon Radio. Yeah, it's complete.
Okay.
They asked me to do it. It wasn't.
Oh, okay, cool.
John B. O'Connor on Twitter, this sounds like the rappers in Times Square. Yeah, we've seen this.
Oh, yeah,
those guys. They signed CDs in front of you.
Hey, man, you like music? You like music?
What's your name?
Yeah. Yeah, I like music. Well, yeah, you're going to love this, man. You're going to love this. It's free.
Oh,
it's free. Yeah, man, just trying to get my music out there. Hey, man, what's your name?
It's Sam.
Sam. All right, yeah. let me write that on this. Sam, sure. You want an autograph, don't you?
Yeah, I'll show my friends out of town.
It's going to be big there. Okay.
Back home.
Yeah, $25.
You said it was free.
Autograph, $25. I'm going to kill you motherfucking white motherfucking crack-ass cracker.
$25. Oh, they hand over the $25. I've seen it happen.
Oh yeah, the fear.
There's a whole fear thing going on.
By the way, there really is a certain. Are they cracking down on that at all?
A little bit.
Not so much.
I still see them out there.
People are gonna have to start taking photos of Virgil when they see him at conventions for me,
please,
because I'm starting an internet venture.
What are you doing?
It's Lonely Virgil on Tumblr.
Lonely Virgil.
That might just take off.
It will launch later today. The name's been registered.
Ah, nice.
Yes.
But see, anyone could just get pictures of him standing there by himself. You got to get like a video that goes fast fucking motion to prove to people no one's coming up at all.
You could send in video. You could send in whatever
lapse.
You want.
It's going to time lapse that shit.
A whole big thing. Hashtag lonely.
Stupid Virgil.
You don't like him?
I love him. I mean, I don't have any...
He loves the story.
Yeah.
It's a great story.
I think he's hilarious.
He's a con man. Jesus. Yeah.
How long since he wrestled?
God, 20 years.
Yeah. And he never wrestled well.
Right?
Why does it say WWE superstar? Nobody gives a fuck.
No, nobody gives a fuck. And he's never been anyone's favorite wrestler.